It's been a while since the Samsung Galaxy S10 has been leaking quite a lot, and till now we've got a pretty good idea how the latest flagship from Samsung would look and feel like. From this leak by the case makers, we see that the Samsung Galaxy S10 will be launched with three variants. At the left, we see the Samsung Galaxy S10e, the cheapest of the trio. At the middle, we see the Samsung Galaxy S10, and at the right, we see the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus with its 12 punch hole display. So Samsung has officially announced the launch date of the Samsung Galaxy S10, and it's on 20th February 2019. But the leaks of the Samsung Galaxy S10 has started to emerge in the internet way earlier. This leak gives us a pretty good idea about how the display would look like in the three models. At the left, we have the Samsung Galaxy S10e. As you can see, of the three devices, the Samsung Galaxy S10e has quite a bit of a bezel. It is because the Samsung Galaxy S10e will have a flat panel display, unlike the curved display in the Galaxy S10 and the S10 Plus. Otherwise, it is a pretty good looking phone. Of the three devices, the Samsung Galaxy S10e and the S10 will have a single punch hole display, but the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus will have a 12 punch hole display for the two front facing cameras. From this leaked image of the Samsung Galaxy S10 and the S10 Plus, we get a pretty good idea about the UI that we will be seeing in the upcoming Samsung flagship device. So we can clearly see that the upcoming Samsung flagship device will be sporting the latest One UI by Samsung on top of Android Pie. Of the three devices, the Samsung Galaxy S10e will boast a dual camera setup, and the Samsung Galaxy S10 and the S10 Plus will have a triple camera setup. This leaked image gives us a pretty good idea of the three camera setup in the Samsung Galaxy S10 and the S10 Plus. You can see that there is also the LED flash at the right side, along with the heart rate sensor. So this leak gives us a pretty good idea about how the front of the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus will look like. As you can see, it has this really beautiful full screen bezel-less curved display, and it looks really amazing. But the 12 punch hole display might not be everyone's cup of tea. That little animation right there at the bottom indicates that the S10 Plus will have an in-display fingerprint scanner. In fact, the regular S10 will also have an in-display fingerprint scanner. As for the Samsung Galaxy S10e, it will have a side-mounted fingerprint scanner on the power button. This latest leaks shows us the boot-up screen of the Samsung Galaxy S10e, and it confirms that the cheaper version of the Samsung Galaxy S10 will be called the Samsung Galaxy S10e and not the Samsung Galaxy S10 Lite, as it was previously suggested by some sources. It also shows the lock screen of the Samsung Galaxy S10e and a little bit of the UI with the notification panel of the Samsung Galaxy S10e. Unsurprisingly, it is evident that it will have One UI on top of Android Pie. Also, one leak indicated that the Samsung Galaxy S10 devices will have some sort of blockchain and cryptocurrency wallet feature, which is a really nice feature to see. Coming to the specs, the Samsung Galaxy S10e will have a 5.8-inch Super AMOLED display with Corning Gorilla Glass 6 protection. The Samsung Galaxy S10 will have a 6.1-inch display with Corning Gorilla Glass 6, and the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus will have a bigger 6.4-inch screen with Corning Gorilla Glass 6 protection. All the three phones will be running Android 9.0 Pie, and the user interface will be the latest One UI by Samsung. Based on the region, all the three devices will be sporting either the 8nm Exynos 9820 octa-core chip or the Qualcomm Snapdragon 855. The Exynos variants will have the Mali G76 MP12 GPU, and the Snapdragon 855 variants will have the Adreno 640 GPU. So the performance on all of the three devices will be pretty similar. The Samsung Galaxy S10 E is rumored to have 6 GB of RAM and 128 GB of storage. The Samsung Galaxy S10 is rumored to have two variants with 6 GB RAM and 12 GB memory, and another variant of 8 GB RAM and 512 GB memory. On the other hand, the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is rumored to have three variants: one with 6 GB RAM, 128 GB storage, 8 GB RAM, 512 GB of storage, and the third variant with whopping 12 GB of RAM and 1 TB of memory. On the camera side, the Samsung Galaxy S10 E is supposed to get a dual camera setup, but on the other hand, the Samsung Galaxy S10 and the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is supposed to get a triple camera setup. For the front camera, the Samsung Galaxy S10 E and the Samsung Galaxy S10 is supposed to get an 8-megapixel front camera on that one-shot display setup. But on the other hand, the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is supposed to get a dual front camera setup on that dual punch-hole display. All the three models is supposed to get a stereo speaker setup. As I have mentioned earlier, the Samsung Galaxy S10 E will get its fingerprint sensor at the power button on the side of the phone. But on the other hand, the Samsung Galaxy S10 and the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus will get an in-display fingerprint scanner. For the battery, the Samsung Galaxy S10 E is rumored to get a 3000 mAh lithium-ion non-removable battery. The Samsung Galaxy S10 is rumored to get a 3300 mAh lithium-ion non-removable battery, and the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus is rumored to get a 4000 mAh non-removable lithium-ion battery. All the three models is supposed to get 15-watt fast charging support and also 15-watt fast wireless charging support. And one more unique thing, well, not unique, because the Mate 20 Pro also has this feature. All the three Samsung Galaxy S10 models is also rumored to get a reverse wireless charging support. Also, one more thing to be noted is that all the three Samsung Galaxy S10 models is supposed to get IP68 dust and water resistance. So that's all for this video. Hope you guys liked it. If you did, do hit that like button below and also subscribe to my channel for more awesome videos.